Good evening, teacher. Microphone. Che, tengo un pequeño problema, solo voy a poder estar de oyente el día de hoy. Hola, hola. No se le escucha, teacher.
Nada. Oh.
Hola, hola.
¿Ahora me escuchan? ¿Can you hear me now?
Yes.
¿Ahora sí se escucha?
Sí, hoy sí.
Está lloviendo bastante por acá. Oh, Ana Beatriz, good evening.
Ah, okay.
¿Se escucha bastante el ruido de la tormenta?
Le decía.
No, no se escucha.
Okay, perfect. Thank you very much. Amber, just tell me. Hi, Amber.
Le decía de que tengo un pequeño problema. Solo voy a poder estar de oyente.
Ah, okay. So are you, I think you're working, right?
Hola.
I think you are working.
No es un tema personal, teacher.
Okay. Pray for me.
Teacher, can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Teacher, it's Galileo. Can you hear me?
Yes, I hear you totally.
You're gonna see in the dark because I am driving from San Salvador to Sultan right now.
My God, it's okay. No, so you can stay connected. Stay connected. No problem.
Okay. Thank you. If you think I am distraído, please.
Distracted.
I pido comprensión.
Yes, it's okay. I will be understanding. Okay.
Thank you, teacher.
All right.
Thank you.
Just to corroborate, solo para corroborar, can everybody hear me well? ¿Todos me escuchan bien? Can everybody hear me well?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Okay. I am asking because in this moment, it is raining a lot in here. Está lloviendo mucho por acá. It's raining a lot in here. So what I will do is that I will force my voice a little bit so you can hear me well. Okay, para que me escuchen bien. So you can hear me well. Okay, good. Let's start. Empecemos entonces. Let's start. So it's basically Friday, the last day of the weekend, the last day of class of this week, right? So estamos en viernes, último día de clases de la semana, last day of the week. And probably the last day of work for many of you. Y probablemente el último día de trabajo para muchos de ustedes, okay? So first,
yeah.
I just want to congratulate the ones who have completed the platform, okay? Quiero tomar un espacio para felicitar a todos los que ya tienen completo el trabajo de la plataforma. Son bastantes, son mayoría, como el 80%, like 80%, okay? So thank you very much. I am very thankful for that. Very grateful, okay? Les agradezco mucho. And thank you very much. Solo hay algunos que ahí les escribí un mensajito que tienen 60%, 40%, o como hay como tres que no han completado, okay? So listen, the idea is that you get 100% in all the activities, okay? La idea es que saquen 100% en todas las actividades. You have the chance or you have the opportunity to repeat the exercises many times, as many times as you can, tantas veces como puedan, as many times as you want, okay? So it's optional. Es opcional si quieren llevar un 80 o un 100 or 100%, okay? I recommend 100%. Yo recomiendo que lleven 100% en todo. 100% in everything. Okay? Very good. So, let me pass the attendance. Déjenme pasar asistencia rápidamente. Oh, by the way, por cierto, también, by the way, quiero felicitar también a Ana Beatriz, específicamente. Hay algunos que han contestado en el foro de discusión. Okay? Algunos empezaron bastante, luego solo uno, luego dos, uno, perdón, y ha ido decayendo, okay? Pero en el caso de Ana Beatriz, ha contestado en todos los foros de discusión. So, thank you very much, Ana Beatriz, for that.
Teacher, okay? Perdón, yo no le entiendo ahí en el foro de discusión.
Ah, okay. So, basically, básicamente, ahí en la plataforma aparece una pestaña que dice discusión, en el menú. Discusión. Haz clic ahí en discusión, y luego abajito aparece como, en la parte izquierda, aparece... temas, creo que les aparece. Temas, ¿verdad, Ana Beatriz? ¿Me equivoco? ¿Así les aparece a ustedes?
Ah, ok. Yes, teacher, yes. Temas.
Temas, y ahí aparecen. Tema. Los últimos se los he ordenado por sesión. Sesión 2, sesión 3 y sesión 5, el último que les puse hoy, ¿ok? Van ordenados. El primero solo se los puse directamente, pero los demás van ordenados por sesión, ¿ok? So you can go there and complete... Yeah, yeah, it's okay. So you can go there and complete the discussion forums, ¿ok? It's not something difficult, okay? Commonly, what you will see on the forums is activities or are activities you complete here in the class. Son actividades que completan en la clase. It's only for you to practice your writing, okay? La idea es que practiquen solamente el writing, la escritura, for you to practice writing, okay? So go, please, traten de hacerlo. Try to do it, to practice writing, okay? Okay, so let me pass the attendance quickly. Oh, pero Ana Beatriz ha completado todos los foros, pero hay algunos también que han completado, como Gloribel, por ejemplo, like Gloribel, for example. Let me see, ¿quién más here? Mauricio creo que ha completado uno, I don't remember. I medio estaba ahí revisando, I was checking, yes, so thank you very much. Christian creo que contestó uno también, ¿verdad? I think Christian answered one. Okay, yes. And, okay, y así hay alguno que olvido, okay. So, but thank you for answering, okay? Gracias por ir a escribir su comentario. Thank you for writing your post, okay? The idea is for you to learn. La idea es para ustedes, que ustedes aprendan, okay? Vocabulario y que ustedes escriban. To practice writing, okay? So, let me pass the attendance. Alejandro Antonio? Alejandro Antonio?
Present, teacher.
Okay. Present, teacher. Thank you, Ana Abigail. Ana Beatriz?
Present.
Cristian. Cristian Lazo.
Present, teacher.
All right. Present, Amber. Teacher. Amber, I think he got connected, right?
Yes. Present.
All right. Okay. Frida.
Present, teacher.
Jacqueline Lizette. Juan Carlos. Alas. Juan Carlos Rivas. Eunice, María Elena, I have a few people connected, Mauricio Antonio, Mauricio,
present.
Okay, thank you, Nelson Gabarrete,
I'm here.
Okay, Omar Francisco, Omar Francisco, Oscar Arnulfo,
present.
Oscar Ernesto. I think Loida Eunice is getting connected, right? Let me put the attendance for Loida here. Okay, Rocío Lourdes.
Ay.
Rocío Lourdes. Rocío is
present,
connected. Ah, okay. I didn't see you yesterday, yes. Rocío. I didn't see you yesterday. Who is here? ¿Quién está aquí?
No, estuve enferma.
Ah, okay, I see. Are you feeling better? ¿Está mejor? Are you feeling better?
Sí.
Okay.
Digamos que sí.
Thanks God. Gracias a Dios. Thanks God. Jacqueline Gloribel.
Present.
Jocelyn Joana.
I'm here.
Okay, Joanna is here, right? Yesenia is not connected, right? She has never. Jose Galileo?
Present, teacher.
Okay, and finally, Dinora. Dinora?
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you very much.
Present.
I didn't see Loida Eunice yesterday either. Ayer tampoco vi a Loida Eunice. I didn't see Loida Eunice. What happened,
yes,
Loida?
Teacher. I can't connect.
Ah, okay, you couldn't get connected, okay? You're here, that's the most important, okay? I texted you, Loida. Ahí te mandé un, Loida. Ahí te mandé un texto de un reminder, de un recordatorio, okay?
Yes, teacher.
So please check it out.
Today
please.
I do.
Okay, yes. Please check it out. Okay, so let's yes, carry on. Continuemos entonces, let's carry on. Okay, listen, just to remember yesterday's class, tell me, anybody, right? Anybody. Can you tell me what we studied yesterday? What did we study yesterday? ¿Qué estudiamos ayer? What did we study yesterday? Can you refresh my mind, please?
The passive voice.
Past participle.
Ah, we studied the passive voice or past participle verbs. That's right. So what did we say about the passive voice? ¿Qué dijimos del passive voice? I'm listening, estoy escuchando, I'm listening. What did we say about the passive voice?
No es necesario ocupar el sujeto.
Ah,
it is who make or who do the fix or whatever, sino que lo que interesa es el sujeto y el la voz, lo que se hizo, la actividad.
Okay, exactly. So that's correct, okay? Actually, the most important in a passive voice sentence is the action. The action. Not the doer of the action. No quien hace la acción. Not the doer of the action. The most important is the action, okay? For example, if I say merchandise is checked every day, merchandise is checked every day, I care about merchandise. Me importa la mercadería, okay? Y que es verificada cada día. Yes? I don't care who does it. En este caso, no me importa quién lo hace. The most important is that merchandise is checked, okay? Merchandise is checked. Very good. So another example. Imagine I say the employees are supervised every day. The employees or the workers are supervised every day. Ah, the most important is that the employees or the workers are supervised every day. That's the most important. Who supervises the workers? I don't care. No importa quién los supervisa. The most important is that they are supervised. Que ellos son supervisados, that they are supervised. So the passive voice is about, or the most important is the action. Not who does the action, no quien hace la acción, okay? Yes, solo para aclarar un poquito, just to make it a little bit clear. And as...
The most important is the action.
That's right, the most important is the action. And as Galileo, I think it was Galileo, or Nelson, I don't remember, said...
Nelson.
Nelson, yes, as Nelson said, como Nelson dijo, as Nelson said, we need a verb in past participle. Necesitamos un verbo en pasado participio. Yo les prometí una lista el día de ayer, ya la tengo... Ya tengo la lista. Okay. Solo déjenme, se me olvidó hoy, pero solo déjenme consultar a Inglés Corporativo porque ellos como que no trabajan con materiales de terceros. Entonces, pero eso es en Zoom. Then let me ask, déjenme hacer la consulta. Okay, let me ask to see if I can share in the WhatsApp group para ver si puedo compartirlo en el grupo de WhatsApp, okay?
Okay.
Okay, so and I will let you know. Y ahí se las envío si me lo permiten, if I am permitted or allowed to do it, okay? Good. So, but here I have a short list. Por aquí tengo una pequeña lista. I have a short list. Check. So basically here, it's loading, just hold on. Espera un momentito que está cargando. Okay, here. Exactly. So basically here I have some verbs in present, in past, and in past participle, que es lo que necesitamos. Okay, ¿qué es lo que necesitamos? el past participle para la voz pasiva, for the passive voice, okay? So for provide, for example, I need provided. For hide, que es esconder, I need hidden. For lead, que es dirigir o liderar, I need led. For sell, I need sold. For speak, I need spoken. For spend, que es gastar, I need spent. And for sweep, que es barrer, I need swept. Okay? Swept, swept. That's right. This is the past participle. Estos son los past participles. Now let me give you one example with provide. Provide, okay? Now I can say, the products for the company, the products for the company are, because it's plural, are provided every week. Okay? The products for the company are provided every week. Los productos para la compañía son provistos cada semana, every week. Or hid, hidden, sorry, hidden. Hidden is like oculto, okay? Oculto. Yes. The money of the company is hidden in a safe place, for example. The money of the company is hidden in a safe place. El dinero de la compañía está oculto en un lugar seguro, in a safe place, okay? Led. Led is like dirigido. I can say, for example, the company is led by the, what? By the general manager, for example, okay? I care about the company being led, okay? Sell is vender, y usamos sold, for example, que es como vendido. Ah, then you say, many products I sold to different clients. Many products are sold to different clients. Muchos productos son vendidos a diferentes clientes, to different clients. Spoken, hablado, okay? Yes, English, I can say English is spoken around the world. English is spoken around the world. El inglés es hablado alrededor del mundo, around the world. Spent, gastado de dinero, right? Yes? Yeah, some money of the company is spent, okay? Some money of the company is spent to pay payrolls, for example, para pagar las planillas, to pay payrolls, okay? Yes? Yes, algún dinero de la compañía es gastado para pagar las planillas, to pay payrolls, is spent, es gastado. And finally, swept, que es barrido. So, básicamente, lo que le estoy diciendo es que en español estos verbos terminan, en ado, ido, so, ok, perdón, to, como visto, provisto, y cho, like hecho, and so on, ok. Then we have swept, barrido. And I can say, for example, barrido. Yes, the offices are swept every morning, ok. The offices, in plural, are swept every morning, ok. Las oficinas son barridas cada mañana. The offices are swept. Or diariamente, exactly, swept, okay? So, very good. So, just to remember, solo para recordar, entonces, aquí también el pasivo usamos el is y usamos el are. If it's plural, are. If it's singular, is, okay?
Is.
Singular is, plural are, okay?
Are singular.
Yes, this is just to remember. Es solo para recordar un poquito, just to remember a little bit, okay? So do you have any questions? ¿Tienen alguna pregunta? Do you have any question about the passive voice? If you don't have any questions, let's go to work. Ahora solo ustedes van a trabajar, yo solo voy a estar monitoring. I will be only monitoring, okay? So do you have any question?
Sure.
Yes? Yes? Alejandro. Alejandro.
¿Por qué unos no cambian en la, cómo se llama? Algunos verbos no se les agregan algunas letras.
Ok.
Maybe unos, spend, led.
Ok. No sé. I was explaining yesterday that in English we have regular and irregular verbs. The irregular verbs, they sometimes change in present, in past, and in past participle. Esos cambian a veces. Pero los regulares, the regular verbs, solo les ponemos ed normalmente o usamos una regla para ponerle ed. Y ya tenemos la forma en past participle, ¿ok? Por eso les estaba diciendo que voy a ver si les comparto una lista de los irregulares, porque son los más complicados. They are the most complicated verbs, ¿ok? Yeah. So, any other question? Do we have any other question? No. Okay. So now, it's time to use the passive voice. Es momento de usar el passive voice. It's time to use the passive voice. So if you want, si quieren, if you want, I will show you this again. Pueden hacer un screenshot aquí a esta lista para que la tengan a su disposición. So you have it ready to use. Make a screenshot. Háganle una captura. Make a screenshot, please. Ready? Did you make the screenshot?
No, no, but...
Okay.
Todavía no, teacher.
Okay, go ahead. Do it. Take your time to do it.
Okay.
All right. So these are some verbs. But yesterday, pero ayer vimos otros verbos, right? Yes, we studied other verbs yesterday. What verbs do you remember? ¿Cuáles verbos recuerdan de los que vimos ayer? Which verbs?
De eso vimos repair.
Repair. Ajá, que le poníamos CD. Repair, para ponerlo en past participle. What else? ¿Qué otro? Known. Known. Sorry?
Great.
Right.
Sin.
Sí, sin. Sin. El past participle. Sin. What else? ¿Qué otro?
By.
By, but, right? But en el past participle. Okay? All right. I can still remember. Sorry?
Rated.
Okay, here. Rated. No, rate.
Yes,
yes. Y consider también, right? Consider. Okay? Here in past participle. Very good. Now listen. In this moment, we will go to breakout rooms in groups of 3 or 4 maximum. The idea is that on this space, on page 16, en ese espacio en la página 16.
Se oye cortado, teacher.
Se oye cortado.
And now,
se escuchó.
Ahora sí se escucha.
Se
now, cortado. Do you hear me? ¿Todavía se escucha cortado?
Yes. Ahorita now? Se escucha bien.
Ah, okay, perfect. So, repeating, the idea is that on this space, on page 16, en la página 16, on page 16, you write a paragraph, escriban un párrafo de 5 líneas, a 5-line paragraph about the reputation of your company, right? About the reputation of your company. Use the passive voice. So the idea is that you use sentences in the passive voice, como las que están arriba, or using the verbs I gave you, o usando los verbos que les acaba de mostrar en la PPT, ¿ok? ¿Yeah?
Examples. Cortado, teacher.
Repeating the idea.
Se le comprende, teacher.
Todos están igual, no me escuchan bien.
Se oye como robot, teacher.
Okay.
No, como tipo robot está hablando.
Déjenme conectarme a otra red entonces. Let me get connected to another network. Now, do you hear me? ¿Ahora me escuchan? Do you hear me better?
Yes.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, ya me conecté a otra red. I got connected to another network. Okay, so as I said, so the idea is that on this space, on page 16, you write a paragraph of 6 lines about the reputation of your company, okay? But please use the passive voice. You can use these verbs. Rate, consider, see, know, rate, or you can use the verbs I just showed you. O pueden usar los verbos que les acabo de mostrar de los que hicieron captura también, okay? Just don't forget, no se les olvide, the verb is in past participle. El verbo va en pasado participio, the verb is in past participle. Y necesitan usar también is or are, okay? Any question? Is or are? Any question? Have you got any question? No? Only 5 lines. Only 5 lines. El párrafo solo es de 5 líneas. It's only 5 lines, okay? Yeah? Using the passive voice. Okay, let's go to working groups. Vamos a trabajar en equipos entonces. Let's go to working groups. Everybody will have the same paragraph. Todos van a tener el mismo párrafo, okay? Everybody will have the same paragraph. Okay, let's go to work.
Podríamos usar el ejemplo que está arriba, no sé.
El de las 5.
6 preguntas creo que eran. Ajá, el de las 5, así es, cabal. El de las 5, no sé.
Ok.
O no sé qué dicen ustedes, ayúdenme ahí porque estoy un poco mal para el inglés, pero estamos para aprender. Este, ¿usamos ese o no sé qué me dicen? Creo que ese.
Yeah.
¿Estamos bien?
It's about the reputation of your company. Okay, we can say, I don't know.
You can use the verbs I gave you too. También pueden usar los verbos que les compartí al principio para el repaso, okay? For example, hello. For example, you can use the verb sell. For example, sell es vender, right? Ajá, el vender. El pasado sería sold, for example. Okay, sold. Ajá, para una buena reputación, ¿cómo podrían usar ese verbo? Ah. Quality products, for example, productos de calidad, quality products are sold, for example. Productos de calidad son vendidos. Quality products are sold, okay? That builds a good reputation. Eso construye una buena reputación, okay? Yeah?
Okay.
Okay, continue, please.
Gracias.
No importa quién. No importa quién haga las cosas, sino que se hagan, ¿verdad? En este caso, pues, la empresa, en mi caso, la empresa Papa John's es conocida por tener mejores ingredientes, mejor pizza, ¿verdad? Nuestro eslogan. Entonces, no importa que cada restaurante, el personal de planta o el personal de mesa, de producción, lo hagan, sino que la pizza en sí es buena. Entonces, de eso se trata el tema, hablar de la reputación de la empresa, no en sí del equipo que hace que esa reputación sea buena.
Que todos tengan la misma razón.
It's basically what builds that good reputation, okay? Básicamente lo que construye o ha construido, has built that good reputation, esa buena reputación. For example, I will give you one example. In Galileo's case, he works at Papa John's, right? So what builds the good reputation of Papa John's, for example? Ah,
yeah.
Great pizzas are made every day, for example. Great pizzas are made every day. O puede ser healthy pizzas, pizzas saludables. Healthy pizzas are made of different tastes, de diferentes sabores, of different tastes, for example, okay? So that builds a good reputation, okay? Eso construye una buena reputación.
Okay.
So, yeah, that's what you have to do, basically, using the passive voice.
Quiero ver qué hay aquí.
Teacher.
Yeah.
It's correct. The company is supplier of occupational safely equipment, and that is okay. is considered a pioneer in the country.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
The example is okay. Can you repeat it? But I want to listen to your example very well. Can you repeat it, please?
Okay. The company is a supplier of occupational safety equipment And equipment. It is considered a pioneer in the country.
Yes, there you have the passive voice. Ahí está el passive voice. That is considered, que es considerado, okay? That is considered a pioneer in the country, okay? Yeah, it's okay, está bien, it's okay.
Supplier,
supplier.
No es, porque es una empresa proveedora. Bueno, somos proveedores de equipos de seguridad ocupacional y somos pioneros en esto porque estamos hace 30 años en el mercado.
Yeah, yeah, it's okay. I mean, the description is perfect, okay? Because you are using the passive voice. When you say that is considered, okay? A pioneer in, yeah. It's okay, está bien. It's a good example.
Thank you.
Okay, but it's one paragraph for everybody. Es un párrafo para todos. The same paragraph, okay? El mismo párrafo, the same paragraph.
Okay.
Yeah, so you need to have...
Is considered...
Yes, so basically you need to have the same information, okay?
Okay.
The same information for
everybody in the group.
El párrafo lo vamos a hacer entre todos.
Yes, that's why you are working in groups.
Okay. Omar, ¿será que me repite para copiarlo, para tener y después hacemos otro o alguien más hace otro?
Ok, lo copiaría el chat.
Ah, ok, that's a good idea, buena idea.
Same information for this group, puede escucharlo.
Little Brown. Ah, ya entró, Charlos.
The company.
Adam Brown. Ahí la podemos poner en el mercado. In the market.
In the market. Okay.
Uh-huh. In the marketplace.
Mm-hmm. No.
¿Cómo se dice llegar en participio? Llegamos a todos lados.
Maybe in this case, you can say we got, or yes, we got okay. Everywhere. We got everywhere.
Every yes. Place or everywhere. Uh-huh.
You can say everywhere. Place. Everywhere is better. Everywhere. Okay. We got everywhere.
We or got
everywhere.
Got
every. Uh-huh.
G-O-T. T. Okay.
G-O-T. Yes.
Okay.
Get in we past. Got we got everywhere.
Everywhere.
Yeah.
Okay.
Remember, the idea is that you use passive voice, okay?
Sí. Company considered. Nosotros tenemos ahorita considerer, rater, no, get, got, mejor dicho, got. Mm.
Yes, but in this case, got is not in passive voice, okay?
Okay.
Remember, to be a passive voice, we need to use are or is, okay? In this case, that sentence is not passive, it's active, okay?
Okay.
But leave the information. But leave the information, okay? Dejen la información, leave the information and try to think of another example in the passive voice, okay?
Okay.
Okay. Bueno, creo que tenemos que arreglar unas cositas, no sé. Dice, in our company... R. Tenemos que aumentar el R. No sé si lo pusieron ustedes al principio.
Después de company. Company are
considered the best production, but the customer, ¿verdad?
Yes.
The company is rated as 5 the most company in the customer service.
Yes.
Después, our company
is now.
Is known.
Known. known. El past participle de know is known. With N at the end. Con N al final. Is known.
Is okay? Known, but leading brand in the market.
Okay.
Okay. We are got everywhere.
Okay, we yeah, but I feel this sentence is in present. Llegamos a todo lugar, but llegamos is in present, right? Llegamos is in present. Then you can say we get is in present. The verb is in present. We get everywhere.
We got everywhere.
We get everywhere. Mm-hmm. Llegamos a todo lugar. We get everywhere.
Okay. Y seguimos creciendo. ¿Verdad, McCormick?
Nice.
Yes. 100%.
Okay. Perfecto. Vamos a algo más que se les ocurra, chicas.
Quedaba entonces llegamos a todo el mundo, alrededor del mundo.
No. Y de ahí solo se le agrega la N. Váyalo ahorita.
No lo veo.
Ahí está.
Ah, no. Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. No. No.
No.
No. Yes, no.
Ahí, ¿qué más? ¿Qué más? Ya se vino.
Vaya, llevamos entonces que es considerada como
una empresa familiar.
Por hacer, ajá, por hacer este, ¿cómo se llama? Etiqueta bordada. Uh-huh. Y por ser una empresa
familiar.
Eso era una compañía familiar, un negocio familiar. ¿Mm? Vaya, otra característica podría ser que son emprendedores porque solo empezaron con lo que es, ¿cómo se llama ese volado? ¿De qué se hacen las listones? Con listones y este, y luego ya se agregó lo que es cordones, elástico, bueno, hoy ya es sublimado, hay transfer, hay este, quiero ver cómo se llama.
Podemos poner que es una empresa que va en crecimiento.
Ajá. No, coloquemos que nuestros productos son supervisados para obtener una buena calidad. Los productos are supervised.
I like the example.
Supervisor son supervisados para tener la mejor calidad. Eso sería en inglés.
Tener la mejor.
Así sería tipo.
To be. Or maybe you can say to have. To have the best quality. To have the best quality. The best. The best quality. The best quality.
Okay.
Yeah.
The best.
Ahí va el infinitive, lo que estuvimos estudiando. Okay, to have, para tener, to have. Okay?
Es que, el párrafo, bueno, la parte decía, our products are supervised. Or have.
To have, ajá.
To have.
To have, our products are supervised to have the best quality. Uh-huh.
Yes. Okay.
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay.
Server con R. Server. Sí, así.
Así. No, con D no será.
Hello.
Hello.
Server.
Hey, lo invitamos a nuestro restaurante.
Thank you very much. Yes, what's your question, Fira?
We serve or we serve?
Que servimos.
It's in present. The verb is in present. You only say we serve. But just don't forget that the idea is to use a verb in, I mean, the passive voice, okay? And here in this example, our clients visit us for the quality service. We serve the freshest vegetables. That's okay. I mean, the example is okay. But the example in this case is in active voice. And the idea is to use a passive voice, okay?
We serve it, entonces.
Ah, okay, it's served. But then you have to say vegetables, okay? The freshest vegetables are served, okay? Are served. So you change the order of the sentence. Cambiamos el orden.
We are fresh vegetables.
The fresh vegetable.
Yeah, it's okay. No. The it's okay. The freshest vegetables are served in the restaurants. You can say are served. Serve with D. Served. Son servidos. In the restaurant, you can say, I don't know.
Freshest vegetables are served. Okay.
Okay, in the first part, and maybe our clients visit us, that verb is in present. Ese verbo va en presente, no visita, in present. No, I mean in number three, our clients visit us. Ese va sin ed, visit. Y ahí the comma is not necessary. You only say visit. Our clients, sin e, without e.
Visit.
Quitemos la e, let's omit the letter e. Okay, yeah, our clients visit us for the quality service. The freshest vegetables are served in the restaurant, yeah? So, in the freshest vegetables are served in the restaurant, ahí tienen la passive voice sentence, ahí tienen la oración en passive voice, okay?
Okay.
And as I said, the most important here are the freshest vegetables, okay? The action, not who makes the vegetables, no quien hace los vegetales, okay? So, the most important is the vegetables, okay? In this sentence.
Y en la segunda línea, teacher, is rated as three best restaurant in the region.
Yes.
It's okay, or?
But what is rated? The restaurant or the company?
Company or restaurant.
You are talking about a company, right? Or restaurant, I don't know.
El restaurante.
Ah, okay, then you can say restaurant directly.
Estoy haciendo la compañía, pero pasamos para restaurante.
Okay, okay. And then in number two, if you don't want to repeat the word restaurant, you say it. It is, okay? It is rated it. For not saying restaurant again, para no decir otra vez restaurante. And it is the restaurant, okay? Yeah?
Okay. Y ese tres, teacher, ¿qué termina? O sea, ahí estamos calificando como con tres. Sería, la calificación es de tres. Pero no, bajo
entre algún... los tres mejores.
Pero, o sea, ¿tres estrellas o tres qué?
Ajá, eso le iba a preguntar. En el ejemplo anterior decía cinco. As five decía.
Aquí tenemos el tres.
But he's talking about the five restaurants, right? About the restaurants, okay? So it is rated as the five best in the region. Five, you can, or three, I don't know, como los mejores tres.
O sea, pero cuando se ocupa el rated, hay que ocupar as y algún número de
yes,
medición.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
Okay, entonces en ese caso sería cinco, que es el máximo que se ocupa en el
número. But you have to say the before five, the five best, okay? The five best in the region, los cinco mejores en la región. The T-H-E. The five best okay. In the region.
Okay.
Or you can say to make it sound like more sophisticated, to make it sound more sophisticated, you can say it is rated as the top five, okay, in the region. The top five. You can use that too. También pueden usar eso. The top five.
Is rated
as the top. Five in the region, huh? It's better, I think. Creo que suena mejor. I think it's better.
Yes.
Estamos diciendo que somos, estamos dentro de esos cinco.
Exactly.
Okay. Bueno, sigamos.
Missing two lines. Dos líneas le faltan. Son cinco líneas. Missing two lines.
bueno, ya hablamos de los vegetales. Bueno, el pan, como hamburguesa.
You can also talk about the customer service, okay? Customer service.
Ese servicio al cliente. Sí, ¿verdad?
Mm-hmm. Yes, it's with you, customer, okay?
Oh, okay, sorry.
No, it's okay, no problem. And it's custo, T-O, right? Customer.
Customer.
Yeah, customer. Yeah, that's correct. The customer service. Mm-hmm. So you can talk about the customer service.
As the best.
Regina, as a leader.
Last year we saw, quiero ver, we look our company's position regional is a leader. Leader.
Bueno, yo solo dos veo, no sé. ¿Cuántos veo usted, Nora?
¿El qué? Perdón.
¿Cuántos en el párrafo, cuántos verbos ve voz pasiva?
Espérame que estoy escribiéndolo.
Ah, está bien, escriba, no hay problema.
Tal vez alguien para que se le facilite y todos están viendo lo que están haciendo. Tal vez alguien del grupo, alguien está trabajando en computadora o todos están en teléfono.
Todos estamos en teléfono.
Ah,
bueno,
okay,
yo soy en teléfono, no sé mis compañeros. Yo creo que también ellos están en teléfono.
¿Y Nora? ¿Cristian?
Yes, teacher. Yes, teacher.
Estamos hablando por chat.
Ah, okay. Ah, okay. Yeah, yeah. No, no, but the question is, are you connected? Están en el chat, dicen.
En el chat estamos.
Ah, okay, okay. No problem. Está bien, it's okay, no problem. Continue, please. Okay,
thank you.
Okay.
¿Usted no puede ver el chat?
Yes, sí lo puedo ver. The reputation of our company is excellent because it is... Okay.
Vean niños.
Can I help you? ¿Puedo ayudarles?
Yes.
¿Sí?
Ahí en la primera donde dice, it is hired new workers last year. Están hablando en presente, no pueden decir last year. Porque si nos metemos al pasado nos vamos a complicar más, ¿ok?
Y entonces.
Maybe you can
le quitamos
say,
last year.
Last year, ajá. Y el sujeto es diferente. You have to say the reputation of our company is excellent because ahí van a decir new workers porque recuerden lo que me importa es la acción. New workers are hired. You can say new workers are hired. Nuevos trabajadores son contratados. Ahí cambia el orden, ¿ok?
Vamos a cambiar cuál, because.
Ajá, el it lo van a quitar, no el it.
Ah, ok. El it,
El it. Y van a decir, en vez de it, new workers, y luego are hired. Are hired.
New worker, last.
Ajá. Ajá, en the new, and new workers are hired.
¿Y de ahí?
Maybe you can say every year, cada año. New workers are hired every year, cada año en vez de last year. Every year.
Okay.
Y luego the company is positioned regionally as a leader in top quality products. That's okay. Eso está bien. And it is so.
Every year.
Ajá. At the products, quality products is okay. Until quality products, and then you continue. And it is sold 100% of our products. The same, es que están confundiendo el orden. Remember, the action is more important. La acción es más importante. So, in this case, donde dice it is sold 100% of our products, cambien el orden. Van a decir 100% of our products are sold. Okay? Are 100? Sold. 100% of our products are sold, okay? Para usar el passive voice. Es como el 100% de nuestros productos son vendidos. Are sold, okay? Uh-huh. Are sold.
Are sold. Uh-huh. Después de one under.
Ajá. Y luego, and then, después de so, ¿ya terminaron ahí esa parte? Did you finish that part?
Yes.
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 And then so is okay. Ahí ese so está bien.
So the company promote
Nelson no.
and Christian to branch
more. Okay. Again, the most important is the action. Okay. So you have to say, so Nelson and Christian, vamos a usar el pasado acá.
Are promote.
No, porque tiene que ser fueron promovidos. Y fueron se dice were. Were promoted. Fueron promovidos. Were promoted. El pasado del verbo to be, que es were. ¿Ok? En Nelson and Christian, were promoted to branch managers of the company. ¿Ok? To branch managers of the company.
¿Ok?
El where se escribe así como se lo voy a escribir en el chat. Where. Nelson and Christian were, y luego promoted, ¿ok? ¿Les aparece en el chat? ¿Does it appear?
Where.
Yes, were promoted. Uh-huh. Ajá, Nelson and Christian were promoted to branch managers. Dinora, do you have it? Dinora, ¿sí lo tienes?
Yeah,
do you have it?
Entonces,
si lo puedes escribir y se los compartes para que no se confundan, maybe.
Lo voy a volver a escribir.
Sí, okay, please, por favor, please. Remember, the problem is that el problema es que están tratando de usar el passive voice, pero se están enfocando en el doer, no en la acción, not in the action. And the idea of the passive voice is to focus on the action, enfocarse en la acción. Okay, not the doer of the action, no quien hace la acción, not the doer of the action, okay?
Okay, teacher. Mire, y eso en la así normalmente se ocupa.
What?
Passive voice.
How normalmente? ¿Cómo normalmente? I don't get you.
No sé.
Yes.
En la vida real.
Yes. 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 When you don't want to mention the doer of the action, you use the passive voice. Cuando no quieres decir quién hace esa acción, usas la passive voice, ¿ok? Yes, use the passive voice.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, but it's very common. Es muy común. It's very common in English.
Es común.
Yes.
Okay.
I think you are about to finish, right? I will give you 2 minutes, pues, 2 minutos más, 2 more minutes, okay?
Oh,
solo lo voy a escribir antes que se salgan, teacher.
Vaya, y lo okay.
No saque.
Ah, y le hacen un screenshot ahí para que lo tengan.
No, o que lo escriban en el chat.
Okay.
Sí, así que no nos saque todavía.
No. Sí, pero when she finishes writing, cuando termine de escribir y lo saco, le va a desaparecer, así que le hacen un screenshot, okay? Le hacen una captura. You make a screenshot, please. Okay? Le va a pasar lo que le pasó a Juan, lo que le pasó a Juan Carlos ayer.
Vaya, chicos.
¿Ya lo compartió?
Okay. Sí, ya.
Vamos a tomar lo que hizo el teacher antes de que me vaya a salir.
Léanlo, a ver si lo entienden.
Ok, the reputation of our company is company difficult in the talks.
Now it's okay, Dinora.
Okay. Thank you, teacher.
Okay, no problem.
good evening, Nelson.
Hello, good evening, Maria.
Hi, good evening, teacher. I'm
sorry. It's okay. Sorry, we were in breakout rooms, okay?
Oh.
Yes. Okay, I think we are waiting for more people to come back. Creo que esperamos a otros que no han llegado todavía, que no han salido de los breakout rooms. But anyways, so I have a quick question, okay? Did you finish? Sí. Yes, Oscar Arnulfo, yes.
Ahí compartieron un par de, una lista de verbos irregulares. Así thank usted you. Ya no pide permiso.
Yeah,
para I'm que not, no le echen la culpa.
Yes, I am just looking at the list, okay? Okay, I am not the one to blame. I am not the one to blame. Yo no soy a quien culpar, okay? I am not the one to blame, okay? So if they say...
El grupo completo.
Teacher, qué feo se oye.
Sorry?
Se oye como un robot.
And now, can you hear me? Ahora
siempre
sí.
Siempre se escucha.
Así se ha estado escuchando todo el rato.
No sé si solo
rato.
Soy yo.
¿Los demás?
No. No, ya se oye, claro. No.
I can hear you.
Okay, you can hear me.
Es por ratos, teacher.
Yeah, the thing is that it rained a lot here. Llovió mucho acá. Seguramente la conexión como que no está muy bien entonces. But when I say something important and you don't hear it, please ask me to repeat, okay? Díganme que lo repita si digo algo importante. If I say something important, okay? So, because I don't know if you are listening well or if you're not listening well, okay? Just if there is something important I mentioned and you don't hear it, tell me please, okay? Díganme, tell me please, okay? Good, so did everyone finish? Did everyone finish?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, okay, so yes. Okay, now listen. The idea, first, how did you work? ¿Cómo trabajaron? How did you work? Do you have a screenshot? Do you have it on your computer? Or how do you have it? ¿Cómo lo tienen? How do you have it?
Writing in the manual.
Writing on the manual. Okay, who has it on the computer or on the cell phone? Who has it on the computer or on the cell phone? Does anyone have it on the computer or on the cell phone? I saw Juan Carlos.
We have it in the chat of group.
You have it on the chat. Okay. So I guess, but do you have any screenshot? ¿Tienen algún screenshot?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. So can you do me a favor, Rocío? Can you please share your paragraph with the class?
Okay.
So the idea is that everybody checks your paragraph and we will check whether it's correct or maybe we can make some corrections together, okay? Para que revisemos juntos, so we check together.
Lo puse en el chat de todos.
Okay, so, aquí es en el chat de todos. Rocío Lourdes, okay, so everybody please. Let's go and check Rocío Lourdes paragraph. Vamos a revisar el párrafo de Rocío Lourdes. Can you go to the chat, please? ¿Podemos ir al chat todos? Now, take a moment and read the paragraph. If you see any error, please tell Rocío. Si vemos algún error, digámosle a Rocío. Let's tell Rocío. Can you go, please? Are you on the chat? ¿Están en el chat todos? Are you on the chat? Okay, let's check. Revisemos. Let's check. So what do you think about their paragraph? What do you think about Rocio's group paragraph? Is it correct or do you have any comment about the paragraph? ¿Tienen algún comentario? Do you have any comment?
When she Arnulfo. Use, when she use our client note in this, don't use participle.
Ah, she is not using the passive voice, okay? Let me see if I find it. It's okay, it's Rocío Lourdes, right? The company is a provider of the occupational safety. Is that the one you're reading, Oscar? Ese es el que estás leyendo. The company is a provider of the equipment.
In the second paragraph, the company sold a safety equipment certificate of third generation or clients now.
Okay, no one. Okay.
No way.
Okay, thank you, Arnulfo. So the sentence is okay, but the sentence is active, okay? La oración está bien, the sentence is okay, but it's in active voice, está de forma activa. ¿Qué estoy enfocando? Los clientes. El doer, quien hace la acción, el doer of the action. But the sentence is okay, pero la oración está bien, the sentence is okay. Any other comment? ¿Algún otro comentario? Maybe about the passive sentences, acerca de las oraciones pasivas, about the passive sentences, do you have any comment? No comments? Okay, let me ask you one question directly. In the, I think it's on the fourth, on the fourth part, en la cuarta parte, where it says the company. The company is sole safety equipment. The company is sole safety equipment. Do you think this sentence is okay? Do you think this sentence is correct? The company is sole safety equipment. What do you think about this sentence? Is it correct or incorrect? What a silence, oh my God. What a silence. So the question is, the company is sole safety equipment. Is this sentence correct or incorrect?
Incorrect.
It's incorrect, exact. Who said incorrect? ¿Quién dijo incorrect? Who said incorrect?
Frida.
What is correct, Frida?
The company sold.
Mm-hmm. Maybe in present, the company sells, but the idea is to give the sentence in the passive voice. La idea es dar la oración en voz pasiva, to give the sentence in passive voice. So,
the safety equipment.
Okay, Jocelyn, can you repeat it?
Dinora, sorry.
Exactly.
Were sold by the company.
Exactly. Remember, the most important is the safety equipment. So I say, the safety equipment is sold, okay? Or the safety equipment of the company is sold. Okay, so cambiamos en vez de company, de sujeto, decimos, the safety equipment of the company is sold, okay? El equipo de seguridad de la compañía es vendido, is sold. So we need to change the order, okay? Good. And then the rest, I think the people are trusted. The people are trusted in the company. ¿Cómo traducen esa oración? How do you translate this sentence? The people are trusted in the company.
Las personas están confiadas o confían en la compañía.
Okay, yeah. Actually, in Spanish, it makes sense, but in English,
la gente somos confiados en la compañía.
Okay, okay.
Confiados en la compañía.
Yes, now listen. We have a problem here. Okay, and the problem is that in English, we have transitive and intransitive verbs. Okay? And what is the difference between transitive and intransitive verbs? Any idea? Have you heard about that? ¿Alguien ha escuchado eso? No?
Oh, teacher.
No. Okay, listen. In the case of transitive verbs, we can use them in the passive voice. But in transitive verbs, we cannot use them in the passive voice. Eso no lo podemos usar. Y trust es uno de ellos. Ese no se puede usar en la passive voice, trust. Okay? Yeah. Okay. So here we better say, mejor digamos, the people trust in the company. Las personas confían en la compañía, in present. The people trust in the company, okay? Yeah. And that's it. Yes, that's all. And that's it. Okay. Now let's see. Now, does anybody else have the paragraph in the computer? ¿Alguien más que tenga el párrafo para compartir? The idea is to check together. Okay, la idea es revisar juntos. The idea is to check together. Nosotros. Who has? Who nosotros? Frida.
Okay. Yes.
Can you share it, please? ¿Puedes compartirlo en el chat? Can you share it on the chat? Okay.
Or okay. Resa is considered the best provider of hamburgers in the country. Hamburgers. It is as the top five in the region because our meat is premium quality. Our clients visit us for the quality service, the freshest, creo que ahí está mal escrito.
Vegetables. No, it's okay, está bien, it's okay.
The quality of service of our employees is approved by our clients. Everyone eating our hamburgers because they are delicious.
Okay. Everything is okay. Except the last sentence. Except the last sentence. The last sentence. Excepto la última oración. Except the last sentence. Everyone eating our hamburgers. Maybe you can say our hamburgers are eaten by everyone. Nuestras hamburguesas son comidas por todos o son consumidas por todos. Our hamburgers are eaten by everyone. Maybe in that way it's possible. Our hamburgers are eaten. Nuestras hamburguesas son consumidas. Hablando de comer, right? Are eaten.
Eaten o
no, eaten. Con E-N, eaten. Es el pasado participio. Ahí luego puedes decir by everyone. Or by. By. Okay, by. By everyone. Uh-huh. Yeah, okay. Now it's okay. Ahora sí está bien. Now it's okay. Okay, thank you for sharing. Gracias por compartir. Thank you for sharing. Good. Can you stop sharing, please? ¿Puedes dejar de compartir? Can you stop sharing? Okay, thank you very much. Now, I said, right, the idea is to use the passive voice. La idea era usar el passive voice, okay? Now, ahora creo que hemos practicado un poquito más. I think we practice a little more, okay? In case you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask. Si hay más preguntas, no duden en preguntar. Don't hesitate to ask, okay? So before we go to the next activity, let me check the attendance. So everybody, thank you for writing your paragraphs. Gracias por escribir ese párrafo. Important. Ténganlo a la mano. Todos deben tenerlo porque el discussion o la discusión es de eso. It's about that. The discussion is about that. So everybody needs to have it. Okay? Alejandro Antonio.
Present, teacher.
Ana Abigail. Ana Beatriz.
Present.
Cristian.
Present.
Ember. Frida.
Present.
Jacqueline Lizette. Oh, Amber is here. Okay. Jacqueline Lizette. No, right. Juan Carlos. Alas. Juan Carlos Rivas.
Right here.
Okay. Loida Unice.
I am here, teacher.
A María Elena. María Elena. Ok, a Mauricio Antonio.
Present.
Nelson Gabarrete.
Aquí.
Omar Francisco.
Present.
Ok, Oscar Arnulfo.
I hear.
Rocío.
Present.
Jacqueline Gloribel.
Present.
Ah, I didn't say Oscar Ernesto, ¿verdad? Oscar Arnulfo, sorry. Oscar Arnulfo.
Yes, I hear.
Okay, good. Oscar Ernesto. Oscar Ernesto is not here. Okay. Jacqueline Gloribel.
Present.
Jacqueline Gloribel, you have the one-on-one session today, right?
Yes.
Yes, okay, perfect. Just to remind you. Jocelyn Joana.
I'm here.
Yesenia. Jose Galileo is present, I think, right?
Present, yeah. Teacher.
Yes. Dinora.
Present.
Okay, very good. So, now please, for a moment, forget about the passive voice. Forget about the passive voice for a moment. I think it's been enough of the passive voice. Creo que ha sido suficiente de passive voice. It's been enough of the passive voice. Now, just to relax a little bit, quick question. Do you like puzzles? Do you like crossword puzzles? What is a crossword puzzle?
Crucigrama.
So do you like crossword puzzles or you don't like them? Or a little, or yes, okay, kind of, okay, good. They make you think too much, right? Good. So it's time to solve a crossword puzzle in teams, okay? So listen, for this activity, you need to go to page 17. Vamos a ir a la página 17. You need to go to page 17 on the photocopy or on the manual, okay? And on this manual, you have a crossword puzzle. And here, you have some definitions, okay? Here you have some definitions. Down is vertical. Down is vertical and across is horizontal, okay? So here you have some values. The idea is that you look for the correct value for the definition. For example, number one, being faithful to your friends, family, principles, etc. What is the value? Number one, being faithful.
Loyalty.
So number one here is loyalty. So write loyalty. Escriban loyalty, write loyalty, okay? And please, this is on page 17. Está en la página 17, it's on page 17, okay? So we need to go in groups again. Vamos a ir otra vez en equipos. Different groups, diferentes equipos, different groups. And complete the crossword puzzle. Completen el crossword puzzle together. Complete it together. Oh my God. The 2 minutes, okay. So I know some of you maybe want to go to the bathroom. So let's take 2 minutes before we make the groups. Antes de hacer los equipos, tomemos 2 minutos entonces. Take 2 minutes, okay? Adelante, go ahead. Take 2 minutes. Tomemos 2 minutos. Take 2 minutes, please.
Nine, arriving or being done at exactly the time that has been arranged.
Dinara tiene el micrófono activado.
Perdón.
Okay, you have 15 seconds. Tenemos 15 segundos. You have 15 seconds. 10 seconds now. Tenemos 10 segundos. We have 10 seconds. Please come back. Regresemos. Please come back.
I'm back. Galileo is back.
Okay, 2 minutes. 2 minutes. 2 minutes. Okay.
I didn't go anywhere.
Okay, so let's see quickly. So listen, the idea in this moment is that we go to breakout rooms and that we complete the crossword puzzle, okay? So please, let's go in groups and let's complete the crossword puzzle, okay? So, creo que no todos han regresado. Not everybody has come back.
Solo una pregunta, teacher.
Yeah.
Down is a vertical, across is a...
Across is across, cruzado, horizontal. Yes, across.
Ah, horizontal. Ese
yes, and down is vertical. Horizontal. Okay, down. Down and across, okay? Down, across. Yes?
Down.
Yeah. Down and across. Very good. Very good. So I will give you numbers. I will give you numbers, okay? So please take notes about the number I'm going to give you. And the number I give you is going to be your group. Okay, the number I give you is going to be your group, okay? So don't forget your number. Que no se les olvide su número. Don't forget your number. Okay, Nelson, number one. Don't forget your number. No olviden su número. Nelson, number one. Christian Lazo, number two.
Okay.
Give me a sign, please. Deme una señal de que han escuchado, okay? Maybe thumbs up, tal vez thumbs up, okay? So, Nelson, number one. Christian, number two. Alejandro, number three. Frida, number four. Frida, number four. Yes? Okay. Jacqueline, number five. Jacqueline Gloribel. Gloribel, number five. Yeah? Okay, perfect. Dinora, number one. Ana Beatriz, number two. Yes. Jocelyn, number three. Jocelyn Joanna. Jocelyn, yes. Maria Elena, number four. Omar Francisco, number five. Juan Carlos, number one. Juan Carlos Rivas. Rivas. Juan Carlos Rivas, number one. Eunice, number two. Eunice, yes. Rocío Lourdes, number three. And Mauricio, number four. Oscar Arnulfo, si me está escuchando, Oscar Arnulfo is number five. Oscar Arnulfo is number five. So I will let you choose the groups and go to the group I told you, right? So please add the group I told you. Oscar Arnulfo, number five, okay? Yes, so please go to the group I told you. Vayan al grupo que yo le dije, okay? So I will invite you to go to groups, okay? So are you ready? ¿Estamos listos? Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, so please go to the group I gave you.
Bueno, yo este realmente lo voy a tener que hacer por números porque no tengo, no lo tengo impreso ni puedo trabajar en.
Nelson, Nelson, maybe don't do the puzzle. Tal vez no escribas, no dibujes el puzzle, si no te vas a tardar mucho. Only write number. Down, for example. Down y luego número uno en the answer y la respuesta solamente en the answer only, okay?
Ah, okay.
Yes. Exactly. If not, it will take you a long time, okay?
Sí. Gracias, teacher.
Okay.
Down y across. Aquí voy a poner la parte cross para no acabar. Y así los números. Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Vaya Juan Carlos, entonces aquí vamos a ponerlo, buscar los valores, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Ok.
Being faithful to your friends, family, principles, etc. ETC, ¿cómo se dice en inglés?
Etc.
Etc.
Etc. Yeah, etc. Okay. I gave you that one. I gave you that one. Okay, that one is loyalty, I said.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, that one is loyalty. So you need to continue with the next. Okay? So if you have the photocopy, complete the puzzle on the photocopy, okay? So Juan Carlos Rivas, do you have the photocopy?
Sí.
Yes, and you, Dinora? You have the photocopy?
Yes.
Yes, okay, so you can complete on the photocopy then, okay? All right, continue working.
Okay.
¿Cuántos habemos, Juan Carlos, y una chica por ahí?
Sí, Dinora.
Yeah.
Dinora no quiere hablar, okay. Va, comenzamos con la primera. Dice, being faithful to your friends.
Me dice la loyalty.
The first one is loyalty.
Loyalty.
Second, the belief that something or someone should not be harmed. Rudely.
Loyalty. Espérame.
Juan Carlos, if you want somebody can share the material, okay? Maybe one person in the group can share the material so everybody is looking at the material. You can do that.
Laptop, I don't do it.
Okay, you don't have a laptop. Nobody has a laptop, right?
Pero es una Mac.
Ah, okay.
Todo registrado.
Mac computers. Mac computers. Hay que botarla donde yo mire esa Mac, sí, entonces. No. I'm kidding. Okay, continue.
La número uno es la de Berdicio, ¿eh?
Yes, it's loyalty. Continue with number two. Check number two together.
It's leadership.
Are you sure?
Empathy.
Yeah.
Number two.
Empathy.
For me, it's empathy.
No.
Check the spaces. Okay, revisen los espacios. Check the spaces on the puzzle.
Ah, no. La dos.
Para mí.
Respect.
Respect.
Respect. Yes, that's the answer. That's the answer. Ladies have the power right now. Ladies have the power in this moment.
Always.
I see.
Always.
Always. Not only right now.
La number three, vamos a ver qué se tiene, cuántos espacios. Ah, es grande. Una, dos, tres.
Doing something well and efficiently.
10 letras.
Ah, no, effectively. Without waste time, money, or energy.
Below you have the values, right? Ahí abajo tienen los valores. Below you have the values on the foot of the page.
Abajo están los valores, ¿cierto?
Yes. They are in orange.
¿Qué pasa?
La tercera, efficiency.
Efficiency. Yeah.
Basito en la energía. No es innovation. No. Don't say anything with an effective control. En el tiempo.
Y la 5. The introduction of new ideas, methods, or innovation. Ese sí es innovation.
La 5. Invent producto innovation.
Me es honesto.
Sí. Es cierto. Integrity, sí. Uh-huh.
Hoy vamos a 4.
Uh-huh.
Y tengo ambición con growing organization.
leadership.
Include and leading a group, organization, country. Leadership.
Leadership. Yeah, the pronunciation is leadership. Leadership. Yes, leadership. 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 Leadership.
Leadership. Leadership. Leadership. Leader. Yes. Teacher, efficient para eficiencia.
Efficiency.
Efficiency.
Yeah, the pronunciation is efficiency. Efficiency.
Efficiency.
Exactly. Efficiency.
Six is responsibility.
Responsibility, Ana. Responsibility. Responsibility. Responsibility.
Teacher, teacher, se puede decir también responsibility.
Yes, it's possible.
It's possible, okay.
Yes.
Number eight is empathy.
Yes, empathy.
You are very assertive. Están muy acertados. You are very assertive.
Punctuality. Punctuality.
Yes. Right. The pronunciation is punctuality. Puntualidad, mm-hmm. Punctuality.
Mm-hmm.
Honest.
La cuatro va. Sí. O solo las de abajo estamos. Las...
No, no, no. Okay, por orden.
Por orden, la cuatro, right? Mm-hmm. Being good at leading a group, organization, country, etc. Leadership, como un líder.
Leadership.
Digo yo. Porque habla sobre liderar a un grupo, organización o país.
O país. Leadership.
Cuente ahí, Yoseli. Cuenta ahí. Ay,
lo descubrió el teacher.
Tiene la cuatro ya. 10, son 10.
Nos están grabando.
2, 4, 6, 10. Cabe.
Cabalita, ¿no?
Cabe.
¿Cuál dijimos usted?
Leadership.
Ok, ahorita.
D-E-R.
Leader.
S-H.
Leadership. Shitba.
Yes.
S-H-I-P.
Are you sure? Are you sure? Count the spaces. Cuéntenos espacios. Count the spaces. Cuéntenos espacios. Count the spaces.
No, es aquí, teacher.
Okay.
Es en el 4, compañero.
Así es que el 9 me parecía 4.
Esto es para que vea que nos hacemos trampa. No lo contamos.
Para ver si se fijaban, lo hice.
A ver si estábamos despiertos.
Sí. El mouse cuando se debería mover no se mueve.
Vaya.
Vaya, ¿dónde? Ya. Ya decía yo porque estaba moviendo este lado. Vaya, esto no lo voy a borrar aquí.
comparto yo, porque lo que estoy haciendo...
Sí, sí. Si gusta, comparto.
Va, ok. Pero tiene que dejar de compartir usted.
Ok.
Something or someone.
Digamos loyalty, efficiency, leadership, innovation. ¿Las dos cuál dijiste que era?
Yo creo.
The belief.
Integrity or respect. Una de esas dos, creo.
No, porque es muy corta. Tal vez respect. Respect. Creo que sí.
Respect.
Ok. La 6. Dice, the quality of behind dependable. Deme la pantalla.
Honesty.
No, la 6 es, ¿puede ser responsibility? No.
Quiero ver. The quality of behind dependable. The quality of behind dependable.
Dependable is dependiente. That you don't depend on anything or anybody. You do it, you can do it alone. Pueden hacerlo solo. You can do it alone.
Eficiencia, no, esa ya estuvo.
Responsibility, no.
Yes. Responsibility makes sense. Responsibility. Using number 6, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Ay, ¿qué hizo otra vez, por Dios? Yo lo voy a volver a trabar.
Responsibility. Maybe.
Fíjate.
Number 7.
Behind. ¿Pero dónde está el 7? Aquí.
Responsibility.
Este es el 7. Behind honest and fair and behaving according to the moral principles that you believe in.
Integrity.
Integrity. Okay. Integrity. Veamos. Integrity, sí. Vaya, 8. The ability to understand how someone feels because you can imagine what it is like to be them. Empathy.
Empathy.
¿Dónde sale mi mamá? Empath. Decirle que estoy en clase, que ya voy.
Empathy.
9. Empathy. Arriving or behind John at exactly the time that had been arranged.
Punctuality.
Siempre me equivoco. Punctuality. Decirle que la doctora no confirmó. Yes. 10, the quality of behind fair and truthful. Solo nos falta una, de todos modos, por descarte.
Por descarte.
Por descarte. Ya sea empathy, responsibility. Honesty no está.
Honesty.
Honesty. Honesty. Honesty. Honesty. Fair and truthful. Honesty, sí, eso es.
Honesty.
Yeah. Honesty, teacher.
Honesty.
Honesty. Okay.
Como la canción de los Beatles, like the song of Beatles. Honesty, I think it's Beatles, creo que de Beatles. Honesty. Okay, honesty.
Honesty.
Yeah, honesty. When you finish, everybody can make a screenshot. Todos les pueden hacer una captura para que lo tengan. Everybody can make a screenshot, okay, to have it.
Okay, pero mi espíritu obsesivo compulsivo no lo ve alineado, así que espérame. Vaya, hoy sí. No, I don't know how writing down.
I am a screenshot.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Be hard. Charo, ya estuvo, ya. Not be harmed. Teacher, aquí se usa bastante el participio.
Sorry?
Aquí se usa bastante el participio.
Where? ¿Dónde? Where? In the sentences.
In the number two, the belief.
Can I see number two? I don't see it from here. I don't see number two from here. Can I see number two? Bajen un poquito ahí. Can you scroll down a little bit? Exactly. Mm-hmm. It's past participle.
Yes.
Should not be harmed. Uh-huh. Yes.
Okay, thank you. Por eso que cuesta encontrar la traducción de primera mano.
Yes.
Okay, perfect. Ya encontré, pues. Okay. Dice creencias. Harmed. What is harmed? Lastimado.
Harm is lastimado. Yes. Oh. O dañado. Harmed. Talking about feelings, right?
Treated,
tratado, treated rudely, tratado rudamente, okay, treated rudely.
Okay. Teacher, is harmed.
Harmed. Okay, harmed.
Is mito the pronunciation?
Where?
Mito?
Methods. Exactly, methods.
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 Otra pregunta para el teacher, the pronunciation. Being.
Being faithful. Mm-hmm.
Being faithful. Teacher.
Yes, Omar. Being faithful. Seven. Number seven.
Behind honesty, home fire, and behaving.
Behaving is like comportándose, right? Behaving according to the moral principles that you believe in. Mm-hmm. Yeah, behaving.
Comportándose, dijo, ¿verdad?
Exactly. Behaving is like comportarse. Behaving is comportándose, obviously, right?
According to the moral principle. Mythos. Okay, the question is being dependable.
Hey, teacher, is seven to the moral principles?
Principles. Yes, you say principles.
Principios morales, ¿verdad?
Yes. That you believe in. En lo que crees. That you believe in. So, have you finished? ¿Terminaron? Did you finish?
Yes.
All right. So, Vamos a regresar entonces. Let's go back.
Okay. Okay. Un gusto, compañeros. Cuídense. Buenas noches.
Buenas noches.
Thank you.
Okay, so did you finish the puzzle? Did you finish the puzzle? Yes or no?
Yes, yes. Yes,
everyone. All right, so let's check. Let's take some time to check quickly. Okay, let me share it with you. Okay, let's see, or let's check first the ones down. Okay, the ones down. Okay, the answers down. La que son verticales, the answers down. Okay. Please, if you have, or I will go directly, like asking, for example, Juan Carlos Rivas, number one, and blah, 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 okay? So please be ready to answer. Estén listos para contestar. Be ready to answer. Okay, let's go to down. Down, vertical is down. Number one is loyalty, right? You have the answer. Number one is loyalty. Yes. Number two, Ana Beatriz. Number two.
Respect.
Respect. Respect. So number two is? Respect. Respect. Very good. Thank respect. You, Beatriz. Respect. Number three, Juan Carlos Rivas.
Efficiency.
Exactly. So number three is efficiency. All right. Efficiency is the pronunciation. Efficiency. Efficiency. That's right. Efficiency. We continue with the ones down. Continuamos con las verticales. We continue with the answers down. Let's see number five. Number five, Omar. Omar Francisco, number five.
It's number five is innovation.
Exactly. Number five is innovation. Thank you. Thank you very much. Innovation. Innovation. Gloribel, number seven.
Integrity.
Exactly, is integrity. Okay, number seven is integrity. Thank you, Gloribel. Now let's go to the ones across. Vamos a las horizontales. Let's go to the ones
okay.
Across. Across. Number number four, Mauricio Antonio, number four.
Leadership.
Leadership, exactly. Number four across is leadership. Nice. Eunice, number six. Across?
It's responsibility.
Exactly. It's responsibility. Responsibility. Good. Thank you. Number eight, Nelson Gabarrete.
Okay. Emphasis.
Sorry, can you repeat it?
Emphasis.
Oh, empathy?
Empathy, yes.
Okay, so the pronunciation is empathy. Empathy, empathy, okay. Empathy, empathy. Okay, so hold on that my connection is really bad. Okay, so number eight is empathy, empathy. Okay, the pronunciation is empathy, empathy. Number eight, number nine. Let's see number nine, Maria Elena.
Punctuality.
Punctuality, exactly, punctuality. So the pronunciation is punctuality, punctuality, punctuality. Very good. Thank you, Maria. That's very good. And the last one, number 10, is obvious, right? Number 10 is obvious. So let's listen to Jocelyn Joanna. Number 10.
Honesty.
Honesty. So number 10 is honesty. Does everybody have the same? Does everybody have the same or different answers? The same?
The same teacher.
The same. All right, perfect. So those are the answers, okay? Good. Now, I want you to help me, like as a class, como clase, everybody, all together, todos juntos, all together. I want you to help me to complete some sentences, okay? So look, here I have some sentences. These are, do you remember the missions and visions? The missions and visions need infinitive verbs, right? The missions and visions need infinitive verbs. Necesitan verbos infinitivos, like, for example, to be, to become, to provide, and so on, right? So we need infinitive verbs. So let's look at the sentences. Revisemos las oraciones. So let's check number one. In number one, do I have any error? ¿Tengo algún error? Do I have any error in number one?
Yeah.
Yes, what is the problem in number one? Who said yes?
ING.
ING. So, what do I say? ¿Qué digo?
To distribute.
No, teacher.
Okay, the problem is that I have the verb with ing. And what is the solution? What is correct? ¿Qué es correcto? What is correct? The company's mission is to
finish in ED.
No, we are not in the passive voice. We are in the infinitives. Estamos en el tema de los infinitives, okay? Y los infinitives llevan to in the verb in present, y el verbo va en presente. For example, to be, to become. Uh-huh. So what is correct here? ¿Qué es correcto acá? What is correct here?
For me, it's correct.
Sorry?
Distribution.
Distribute. So the correct answer is, so we omit the ing, le quitamos el ing. And we say the company's mission is to distribute top quality office supplies. Okay, distribute. So that is the answer. Y si tienen la fotocopia, if you have the photocopy, make the correction. Hagan la corrección. It's on page 18. Es en la página 18. It's on page 18. Page 18. Number two, what is the problem in number two?
Eat.
What do we say? ¿Qué decimos? What do we say?
Is,
exactly. We say is. So our vision is to become the leaders in the telecommunications sector. Okay, thank you very much. Our vision is to become, okay?
Se le va la señal, profe, repítame.
Our vision is to become. En vez de elite, we say is. Okay? Yes. Let's see number three. In number three, what is the problem?
Four.
What is the problem with four?
Must say we exist to provide.
Exactly. Four is not necessary. Four is not necessary. El four no es necesario. It's not necessary. So we say we exist to provide integrated logistics services. Okay? Very good. Let's continue. Number four. What is the problem in number four?
El verbo to be.
We say our goal is to be. Okay? Nuestra meta es ser. Our goal is to be recognized as the number one dairy producer. Is to be recognized, okay? Ser reconocidos, is to be recognized. Let's see number five. What is the problem in number five?
Becoming,
the same problem. Okay, what do I say? ¿Qué digo en vez de becoming? What do I say?
Become,
in present. Become like this, okay? Become, así. Our Rex ambitions to become, okay? To become the number one manufacturer of clothes for kids, okay? Yeah. Okay, thank you for your help. Gracias por su ayuda, thank you for your help. Let me pass the attendance quickly again. Déjenme pasar la asistencia rápido otra vez. Alejandro Antonio.
I'm here, teacher.
Ana Abigail, Ana Beatriz,
present.
Cristian Ernesto,
present.
Amber, Frida,
present.
Jacqueline Lisset, Juan Carlos Alas, Juan Carlos Rivas,
here.
Okay, Carla Janet, Loida Eunice,
I'm here.
María Elena.
I'm here.
Mauricio Antonio.
Present.
Nelson Gabarrete.
I'm here.
Omar Francisco.
Present.
Oscar Arnulfo.
Present.
Oscar Francisco. No, right. Oscar Francisco. Nelson Gabarrete. Sorry, I didn't say Nelson Gabarrete.
I'm here.
María Elena.
I'm here.
Okay. Rocío.
Present.
Omar Francisco is here.
Present.
Okay. Let's see. Rocío.
Present.
Jacqueline Gloribel.
Present.
Jocelyn Joana.
I'm here.
Yesenia. José Galileo.
Present, teacher.
And Dinora.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you very much. No se vayan a salir porque ya pasó asistencia. We have 8 minutes. Okay, we have 8 minutes. Good.
Goodbye, teacher.
No, it's Friday, teacher. No, it's Friday.
And see it's you tomorrow, party. Teacher.
I just remember it's Friday. It's Friday. Y el cuerpo lo sabe, okay?
And the body knows it.
No, it's Friday. Yeah. It's Friday and it's party time, okay? Don't say the body knows it and it's party time, okay? Good. It's Friday, but we have 7 minutes to finish the class, okay? Okay, quick question. I have 2 words. What is the difference between these 2 words? Word number one. Word number one is personal. And word number two is personal. What is the difference?
Personal.
Primera, singular, otra plural.
Okay, I don't think so. Let's listen to Mauricio.
La segunda es personal. Es
personal. Personal.
Personal is money.
And personal is?
Is otra persona.
Otras personas. Okay. So look, personal is okay, right? I have, I need personal information. Personal, something belonging to you. Personal, algo perteneciente a mí. Personal, right? Or maybe I can say, do you have a personal assistant? Do you have a personal assistant? Un asistente personal. So personal, belonging to me, okay? Que me pertenece, belonging to me. But what about personal? ¿Qué hay de personal?
¿Qué pertenece?
Personalidad.
No, that is personality. What is personal? Or they are the same, o son lo mismo, or they are the same.
Son lo mismo, quizás.
No. Varias personas.
I got you. Varias personas. Okay. Now listen.
Okay, there's a lot of people.
Yes. Personal is belonging to me, right? Personal information, a personal assistant. What? A personal something, okay? Something belonging to me, personal. And personnel. In the working area, en el área de trabajo, personal is personal. What is that?
People work in the place.
That's right. People who work in a company, the personnel, the staff, we say, right? The staff of the company, the personnel of the company, okay? That is the difference. Personnel are the staff of the company, all right? And personal is something belonging to me, all right? Algo que me pertenece. Personal information, personal assistant, personal secretary, personal receptionist, I don't know, okay? So it's something personal, yeah? Yes?
Yes.
Okay, let's see. Juan Carlos Rivas, what is the difference between personal and personal?
Personal belong me.
Yeah, personal.
Personal pertenece a... Eso, personal de alguna empresa.
Yes, personal de trabajo. Okay, personal. Okay. The employees, or you can say the staff. Okay, the staff. All right, we say staff. As you can see on the chart, sometimes we have staff. Okay, that's personal. Eso es personal, okay? Very good.
Persona.
Yes. Taking that into account, considerando eso, taking that into account, I want you to help me with this activity. Quiero que me ayuden con esta actividad. I want you to help me with this activity. Okay, here we need to complete these questions or sentences using personal or personal. Check number one. What is the correct word in number one?
Personal
or personnel?
Personnel.
Exactly. It's personnel. It's this one, personnel. Okay? Personnel. Yes. Okay. So it's personal, basically. So you say, who is responsible for the personnel at the plant? For the workers, okay? The personnel at the plant. Number two.
Personal.
Exactly, it's personal. Does the marketing manager have a personal assistant, okay? Un asistente personal, a personal assistant. What about number three?
Personal. Bring more personnel.
Personnel, exactly. Personal or personnel?
Personal.
Personal.
Okay, because we have to see the pronunciation too, okay? So it's personal and personnel. Okay, personal and personal. So, number three, what is the answer? Personal or personnel?
Personal.
Okay, it's personal. No. Good. It's necessary to train more personnel for the high season. Good. Number yes. four.
Personal.
Exactly. Please do not bring your personal problems to the office. Problemas personales, your personal problems to the office. This one.
Personnel.
Sorry?
Personnel.
The personnel of the workshop need new uniforms. Exactly, the personnel. Okay, the personnel. Talking about the staff, okay? Last activity. Última actividad ya para dejarlos ir. I want to let you go right now, okay, ya. Ya quiero dejar, no, es la unidad 2, it's unit number 2. It's here, está por acá arribita. It's here, I think. Okay. So listen, here I have some vocabulary. Por aquí está algún vocabulario. I have be in charge of, be committed to, be dedicated to, be responsible for, and be accountable for. Okay? Anybody... Cualquiera que me dé un ejemplo, me dan los 5 ejemplos y nos vamos ahorita. And we go quickly. First, using be in charge of. Primero usando be in charge of. Tell me one example, un ejemplo.
The manager.
Oh, okay, say the example.
The manager be in charge. No, okay.
Is because be is or are. We say is or are, okay? Is.
The general manager is in charge of world... company.
Okay.
The whole operation of the company.
Good. The general manager is in charge of the whole operation of the company. It's okay. Yeah. Although, however, the idea is to use a verb with ing. La idea es usar un verbo con ing, but the example is okay. Okay. Maybe you can say the general manager is in charge of supervising, maybe. The whole processes of the company, okay? Supervising the whole processes of the company, okay?
I got it.
What is be committed to? ¿Qué es be committed to? Do you remember?
Estar comprometido
a. Be committed to. Example, ejemplo, example.
Okay,
Mauricio. Mauricio Antonio.
We are committed to studying English.
Good, that's excellent. Oh, I like the example. Creo que le voy a poner 100% en todas a Mauricio ahorita. We are committed to studying English. El verbo con ing, studying. We are committed to studying English. Estamos comprometidos a estudiar inglés. I like that. Okay, good. Next, siguiente. Be dedicated to, estar dedicado a, be dedicated to. So, example.
What?
Oh, okay, who says work?
Working.
Who is speaking? Work. Edgar. I mean, who is speaking? ¿Quién está hablando? Nelson.
Nelson.
Okay, Nelson, tell me the example. I am, you say I am.
I am
dedicated
to in the world.
To working.
To working
in the company, you can say.
Very hard.
or maybe you can say, I am dedicated to giving my best in the company, para dar lo mejor, to giving my best in the company. Okay?
Dar lo mejor en la compañía.
Uh-huh, you say to giving my best in the company. Exactly.
Okay.
Next, be responsible for, estar ser responsable. Okay, Ana Beatriz.
I am responsibly checking the close order.
Repeat it, please.
I am responsibly.
For?
For checking.
Yes.
Close the order.
Oh, good. That's excellent. I am responsible for checking. Good. That's excellent. Thank you. The last one, be accountable for. It's the same as be responsible for, right? They are synonyms. Son sinónimos, they're synonyms.
Ah, they're
so, the example for be accountable for?
Be accountable for paying the box.
Good. I am accountable for paying?
The books.
Okay. I am accountable for paying the books. Good. That's excellent. Oh my God. I can see you want to go quickly. Ya veo que se quieren ir rápido. Okay. Okay, so. Yes, I know you are tired. I know you are tired. Yo sé que están cansados. It's Friday. Okay, everybody. So basically, we finished unit number one. And we finished week number one. So thank you very much for your patience. Thank you very much for working so hard. Thank you very much for being very good students, okay? So thank you for everything. So so basically, that's it for today. No se les olvide completar la plataforma, los que están pendientes aún. And well, thank you for everything. Good night, goodbye, and have a good weekend. Tengan un bonito fin de semana. Have a good weekend.
Thank you. Bye.
See you on Monday.
Good night.
Teacher, estoy tratando de ingresar, pero no sé, la tengo que recuperar la contraseña.
¿Se te bloqueó, Eunice?
Yo creo.
¿Qué te parece?
Ya me mandó un correo.
Tienes que esperar 24 horas si se te acaba de bloquear ahorita.
Ah.
¿A qué hora se te bloqueó el usuario?
Ahorita en lo que estaba en la clase, intentaba entrar, pero me mandó un correo que dice que descargue, importe los siguientes archivos. No sé.
Realmente no sé lo del correo. Lo que sé es que cuando se bloquea el usuario, lo que pasa es que debo esperar 24 horas para que se desbloquee automáticamente el usuario, en caso de que el usuario esté bloqueado. Pero yo creo que no es este el caso, ¿verdad? ¿O sí?
A mí me pareció que se bloqueó. Y que intenté dos veces y de la nada me dijo que se había bloqueado. Solo eran dos veces, no eran así un montón.
I'm sorry, pero si está bloqueado. Está bien, yo voy a reportar el caso de que se te bloqueó el usuario, que por eso no has completado, pero complétalo mañana, entonces tendrías que estar completando a esta hora más o menos. Porque ahorita no lo vas a desbloquear, aunque estés intentando, mejor déjalo así ahorita si se te bloqueó y mañana intentas mejor. ¿Ok?
Ok, teacher. Thank you, sorry.
All right, it's okay. I will see you later. Okay, bye, good night. Okay, Glorybell, so this space is for you as always. So I'm all ears. Soy todo oídos ahorita. I'm all ears.
Podríamos repasar el de ing verbs after preposition.
Ing verbs plus prepositions.
After preposition.
Okay. Ing after prepositions. Okay. Okay, basically, básicamente, let me share screens. We have different prepositions, right? Tenemos diferentes preposiciones. En este caso, in this case, in this specific case, solo hemos visto algunas. We have seen some only, okay? Hemos visto algunas nada más. Pero tenemos más. So, which prepositions have we studied, for example? ¿Cuáles hemos visto?
For, to.
Okay, of, to. For, ¿cuál otra? Only that, solo esas.
Only that.
Only that. También podría ser about, ¿ok? Cualquier preposición, any preposition. About.
Es sobre.
Ajá, es acerca de, about. About, ¿ok? Podría ser también in. All right? So, la idea es, the idea is that after prepositions, if we use a verb, we use it with ing. Después de cualquier preposición, si usamos un verbo, va con ing. It's with ing, okay? That's the idea here, yeah? For example, empecemos con la primera. Let's start with the first. The first preposition is of, right? Of. I will give you an example that is not on the material, maybe, okay? Imagine I say, I am thinking, okay? I am thinking, estoy pensando. I am thinking of, for example, estoy pensando en, uso esta preposición. I am thinking of changing, for example, changing group. Estoy pensando en cambiar grupo. I am thinking of changing group, okay, for example, okay? So, the preposition is of. So, el verbo que uso, siempre lleva ing. It's always with ing, okay? Imagine I say I am, or I will say I am, no. I will say they. They are interested, for example. They are interested, están interesados, ellos, okay? They are interested in, están interesados en, they are interested in, in what? ¿Cuál verbo podría usar? ¿Están interesados en qué?
Aprender. Learning.
In learning, okay, in learning English, for example. They are interested in learning English, okay? What is the preposition? In. The verb is learn. So the verb is with ing. El verbo va con ing, okay?
Okay.
Yeah, so basically that's it. And then lo que hemos visto, responsible for example. For example, if I ask you, Gloribel, what are you responsible for? ¿De qué eres responsable tú? And then you say, I am responsible for, y luego puedes usar un verbo. Responsible for what, for example, in your company?
Checking my email.
Yes, then you say, I am responsible for checking, the verb with ing, I am responsible for checking my email, okay?
I am responsible
for checking. For checking my email.
Mm-hmm. My email.
Exactly. So what are you committed to? ¿A qué estás comprometida?
Sería como de llegar temprano, algo así.
Ah, exactly. Then you say, I am committed.
I am committed.
To arriving.
Arriving.
To work. Early, okay? Ese arrive, como es el verbo, después de to, le ponemos ing, to arriving. To arriving to work early. Mm-hmm. Yes?
Okay.
Yeah. Básicamente eso. It's very easy. Es bastante fácil. It's very easy, okay?
¿Y cuál es la diferencia entre responsible y accountable?
What I know is that accountable is used with the same purpose. Se usa con el mismo propósito de responsable.
Es sinónimo.
Ajá, they're synonyms, son sinónimos. That's what I know. Eso es lo que yo sé. That's what I know. I don't know if there's something else. No sé si realmente hay algo más, pero that's what I know. It's the same use, basically. Los he visto con el mismo uso. With the same purpose.
Lo último que vimos de personal y personal.
Ah, personal and personal. Ajá. So basically, básicamente, lo que les decía. Okay, let me share screen. Déjame compartirte pantalla. So basically, when you say personal, okay, es algo personal, algo que me pertenece. Okay, y teníamos el ejemplo. Personal problems, okay, personal problems, problemas personales, personal problems. Es algo que me pertenece, the problems, right? They belong to me, me pertenecen a mí, they belong to me. Or a personal assistant, el ejemplo que veíamos, un asistente personal, personal assistant, okay? And then we have, personnel. Luego tenemos personnel. Aquí sería igual personal, pero personal de work, personal de trabajo, ¿ok? Personal, talking about work, hablando de trabajo, personal. ¿Ok?
Ok.
You can say, for example, all the personnel of the company has a training today. Todo el personal de la empresa tiene un, ¿qué? Una capacitación hoy. All the personnel of the company have a training today.
Uh-huh. Ahí no diríamos personal, no, sino que personal.
Personal, porque me refiero al personal de la empresa, a las personas que trabajan ahí de personal, ¿ok?
Ok.
Yeah.
Y un medio repaso de cuándo usar, how to use the passive voice.
The passive voice. Básicamente, yo sé que eso los tiene a todos bien intrigados. Sí. Okay, so basically, lo que tenemos que ver es la estructura, okay? Primero va la acción o el subject, vamos a decir el subject, okay, let me erase here. Primero va el subject, okay? Que sería la acción, right? Luego iría el verbo to be, que sería is, o podría ser are, okay? Then we have el verbo, pero en past participle, lo que hemos estado viendo. En past participle, el verbo va en pasado participio, que está en la lista que le di, por ejemplo, ¿ok? Y luego puede ir un complemento. Y normalmente a veces podemos usar by en el complemento, ¿ok? Veamos un ejemplo. Let's see one example. Let's see one example. Okay, let me look for a different color. So I can say, for example, the what? Vamos a aplicar el vocabulario. We are going to practice the vocabulary. The personnel, for example. Okay, el personal. En general, right? Vamos a decir are porque es el personal en plural. Okay, the personnel are. You can say supervised, okay? Supervised. Voy a usar by en este caso. By the supervisors, okay? Supervisors, okay? El personal es supervisado por el supervisor. So, básicamente, esta es la estructura. El verbo to be y el verbo en pasado participio.
En pasado.
Ajá, en pasado participio, en past participle, ¿ok? De acuerdo a la oración, what is important? ¿Qué es importante? El personal. ¿Quién nos supervisa? Lo he puesto, pero realmente lo importante es que el personal es supervisado, no quien nos supervisa, ¿ok? Esa es la idea del passive voice.
Es más importante la acción.
Exacto.
Que quien realiza.
La acción. Uh-huh. Eso es. Okay. Eso es la voz pasiva. Es más importante la acción que quien realiza esa acción. ¿Ok?
Ok.
Okay. So that's it.
Only that.
Okay. So so thank you very much, Bloody Well, for connecting to this one-on-one session. Espero que te haya ayudado. I hope it was helpful.
Sí.
Okay. Okay, so thank you very much. Okay, thank you very much. Good night and have a good weekend. Ten un buen fin de semana. Okay, bye.
You're welcome.
Okay. Bye.